Welcome back to the Habs Podcast, guys. Welcome back to a brand new video. Thank you so much for coming back to a new podcast. We are at 90 subscribers, guys. Let's get to 100 before 2025. And thank you so much for the love and support. Make sure follow us on all our social medias down below. And let's get to 100 subscribers. Like, comment, and subscribe.
Yes.
And so, share the video.
Perfect recap. So let's start by talking about the Habs that played Saturday against the Vegas Golden Knights. What were your thoughts on this game, on this big blowout? How disappointing is it after a win against the Oilers?
I mean, man, like that win versus the Oilers, I was so happy because we handled probably the best offensive team. But now, the night before, the cancer night for everybody, Martin Saint-Louis saying, you got to go out there and fight. And it did not look like that,
which was disappointing. The effort was terrible. I don't understand why this
team... Yeah, and considering it was the cancer night.
Yeah, like, and why does this team keep giving up after giving one goal? Like, come on, keep playing. It doesn't matter if it's 1-0 for them. You got to still keep fighting. You can't allow 5 goals in a period. Everyone is to blame for that. Do you agree?
Yeah, I agree with you. And I also want to talk about Martin Saint-Louis. Like, why is he putting Slafkovský on the fourth line? Like, why not this Christian? Look at this Christian Dvorak. What is he doing?
Yeah, like today in practice, he put Dvorak second line. Like, today against Yuta, he might be on the second line. What is that? Like, how is that fair? Like, he ain't better than Slav. Newhook ain't better than Slav. He's on the first line.
Okay. Yeah, that's crazy.
I don't understand what is that guy smoking.
Yeah, I know. I think he's been meeting up with Josh Lahak recently.
So I want to talk to you about something. So Kirby Doc has been struggling recently. Why do you think he hasn't been performing? What are your overall thoughts on him? And do you think he should have been benched last game?
I mean, listen, man. Like, it's hard to explain because, like, you know, I understand he's coming back from an injury, but, you know, considering, like, it was an important night versus Vegas, you know, there's people out there battling for their life, and you cannot do a simple forecheck for them, give effort. Like, that's what disappoints me about Kirby Doc. Like, I understand if he can't produce points, but at least, like, show that you give, like, you care.
Like, yeah, like you said, like, he does have the injury excuse, but at the same time, like, we need more effort from that guy. You know, like, it's not like he missed out, like, 5 years without playing hockey. Why is he playing like Ryan Reeves and, like, doing turnovers? Like, what is happening? He needs to step up. Kirby Doc needs to step up, you know? And I don't think he's going to improve by playing fourth line, okay? Like, I know he's been bad, but Martin Saint-Louis needs to support him. We just need to make normal lines, you know?
Yeah, and what do you, like, think about...
We called the Bois.
Do you feel bad for Samuel Montembeau? Because I feel like he played well versus Vegas.
Well, I mean, he had a good first period, but I wouldn't say he played well. Like, come on, we're going to see soon the goals of the second period. Look at the fifth Vegas goal. What a terrible rebound that was. So I would say... I don't like Montembeau's consistency. You know, you want to prove yourself. You're up against Adin Heil. You want to play
for Team
Canada.
He shut out the Oilers, then he gets 5 goals.
Like, this is average Montembeau, you know? And I'm saying this as a Montembeau fan. Like, he just needs to set up his game. Also, I want to talk about another case. Mike Madison has been a defensive disaster.
Yeah, I mean...
Like, what is going on? And why didn't we trade him this offseason?
I mean, man, you were right. You called it even last year that we should have traded him. And, like... It's crazy because I feel like we really need two good, better veterans because this blue line is too young, and we know it. David Savard is, like, yes, he's a good leader, but we need that number one veteran.
Yeah,
and
we
thought
too
it was Matheson.
Players.
We thought it was Matheson, and clearly he's not. He's a defensive mess.
No, but what's annoying with Matheson is that he's really fast. He's good on offense, but he has zero defensive IQ. Like, Mike Matheson has the defensive IQ of a turtle. Like, what is he doing?
Yeah.
Like, you're going to see going to see on the 2-on-0 for Vegas soon. Like, what is Matheson doing? He's skating towards the net. It's a 2-on-1. Anyways, we're going to see the play later.
Like,
but
it looked like Matheson was joining the rush with Vegas.
Yeah, like, what is he doing? And send Matheson to the second pair and to the second power play unit. Why does this guy have to be our number one night in and night out? Like, he's out of gas. Like, he's bad. And he's bad defensively and doesn't help him to play 25 minutes a night.
Yeah, I think the problem is we need another veteran. Like, we need to go out there and get somebody better than him because we cannot let a guy like Lane...
But he doesn't lead by example. Like, come on, he doesn't defend.
Care, and we cannot let, like, guys like Lane Hudson get 30 minutes. He did it last time and we cannot...
Like, Kirby Doc, look at that. Kirby Doc, we're talking about that. That's bad.
He looks completely lost.
Yeah, he needs to step up his game. I guess it was his injury, but come on, more effort than this. Why are you not moving?
He's watching the puck. Let's go back here.
Yeah, the guy's
puck watching.
He's puck watching.
After his turnover, no effort.
Yeah, he doesn't.
He's watching the puck, leaving the slot wide open.
You're a center.
Look at this, two Canadians on the same side. Look at Doc and Konoda on the same side. Like, who are they guarding?
Yeah, it's
this
crazy.
This is horrible defense.
Yeah, and that's
like,
you can't blame an injury on that. He has to step up. He has to give up.
Yeah.
To give more effort.
Yeah.
But also, like, before we move on, I need to show this 2-on-1 on the next goal. Well, we're gonna see it soon, anyways.
Yeah. Oh yeah, it's here.
Turnover
by Slavkovsky.
So, Slavkovsky makes a turnover, and now you're gonna see Madison. Like, I have never seen someone play a 2-on-1 so terribly. Why is he going back? What is he doing? Come on.
He did not have time, but you have to dive.
And because this is usual stuff for Madison, you know. It's just it happens all the time.
I mean, like, look at this.
Like, no, you gotta have the reflect. Like, how do you call that? Like the instinct to just go backwards. You're a defenseman. And he's doing this too many times. Like, if I'm Martese, I would put him second unit. I would put him second unit. Hudson is great first unit, so why is this guy playing first unit? I don't get it.
And yeah, and finally, after all of this, we call up Joshua Roy, finally makes...
We call up to play him on the third line.
Yeah.
Like, do you really think he's going to produce with Eidemann and Evans? No, he's not. Like, why? What is going on? Like, Roy should be second line. He should.
And
like,
I have a question
for you.
He's
tearing up the IHL. What is going on?
I have a question for you. Looking at how Doc has been performing, would you consider changing the first power play unit and replace him with Joshua Roy?
I would. You know, maybe for one game, two games, just to tell him a message. How do you let Tanner Pearson score? Like, this guy can't even score in my beer league. Like, come on. Why is he? Anyways, yeah.
Yeah, I'm sorry to interrupt.
Disappointing.
Continue on.
Doc, I would say a second power play unit for a few games. And when Liney comes back, maybe you can think about re-putting him in. You know?
Yeah, and these are all small defensive mistakes. Look at Caulfield here. He should have went on his man on the slot. Like, you see.
Yeah, I think that's the reason USA doesn't want him on
look,
the team. Like, I
right
love Caulfield,
there, they
but,
leave the slot yeah. wide. This you cannot leave the slot wide open. Like, it's harder for a goaltender to make a save. And yeah, we
anyways,
pay the price.
Let's move on to the predictions of the week. So this week, the Montreal Canadiens are playing UDA tonight, the UDA Hockey Club, first ever game between the two clubs. Then Wednesday, they're against the Blue Jackets on the road. Saturday, they're against the Rangers on the road, and Boston also on the road Sunday for Thanksgiving weekend in America. How many points are we getting this week?
Listen, man, I think tonight and versus Columbus. Even though we're playing tonight and versus Columbus, tomorrow, we're playing two games in two nights. Even though we're playing two games in two nights, I think we can win those two games. And I think...
Are you crazy?
we're going to lose the weekend. But besides that, I think we can get 4 points out of eight. In my opinion, we can at least get 4 points out of eight.
So you think this weekend we're going to lose both games?
Yeah.
Okay.
But at the end of the day, like... I want us to get 4 points out of eight, and I think we're
going
to do it.
I'm going 2 points out of eight, okay? I think we're going to lose every game. I think Columbus is the only game we can actually win, you know, because they're not the best team ever, you know. They're pretty much our level, right? And I know we're playing two games in tonight, but still, man, I feel like we're going to lose to Utah and bounce back against Columbus. But yeah, this weekend is going to be rough, man. The Rangers and Bruins are two great teams, and I know they both had their struggles recently, but still, I think they're going to edge us out.
So now
let's move on to Jay Montgomery.
Yeah.
Hired by the St. Louis Blues. Drew Bannister was fired and Jay Montgomery hired only 5 days after being fired by the Boston Bruins. What did you think about that?
Now my question to you is let's go back here. Why did Boston Bruins fire him? Like, he had a great record, but do you think, was he really the problem in Boston?
No, he was not. You know, he led them to a record-winning season. I would have waited a few games before firing him, you know. But I would say, like, I think he's going to be great for St. Louis, you know. And it's crazy because the Bruins have fired Bruce Cassidy, Claude Julien, and Jim Montgomery in, like, less than 10 years. And the next few days, they were already hired. So I feel like the Bruins management needs to look at themselves in the mirror and, like, tell themselves, we can't blame the coach for all the problems we're doing with the trades. But, I mean, at the same time, you know, I think it's always the easiest thing to do is to fire the coach.
Yeah.
So if I was Boston, I would still have waited a few games to see maybe if they respond. But it didn't happen. And, yeah, it's a bit weird. But yeah, I think St. Louis, like, they fired Drew Bannister because, like, they saw an opportunity to hire a competent coach that can help them win, that can fit in the system. And also, we have to remember he played for the Blues, you know, back in the 90s.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So, no, he's a great coach, you know. I do think he's like a tactic coach.
So now, how do you like this for Blues now? What is your point of view on the Blues here?
Yeah, well, exactly like what I just said, you know. I think, like, they saw Drew Bannister, their current coach, like, who wasn't the best. And even if he was a new coach, Bannister, they still fired him because they saw an opportunity to hire a better coach. And I do think he's going to do great, but he's not going to do great enough that the St. Louis Blues are going to make the playoffs. But it's been working out. They won 5-2 yesterday in his first game.
So, yeah. Now, let's move on here to...
the Rangers situation.
Yeah.
So... Jim Montgomery, the New York Rangers, and Chris Drury, their GM, announced that Chris Kreider and Jacob Trouba are on the trade block and that they want to shake up the core. What do you think about that?
I don't know. Is every GM smoking this year? Like, I'm really not sure because, like, why? That's my question. Why? Like, I understand. They're not even, like, are they trying to retool?
I think it's a message. Because the Rangers right now are struggling. They lost 3 games in a row. They got destroyed against Edmonton and Alberta. I think it's a message.
So, are they done?
I don't think they're really going to trade him. Like, I can't believe they would actually trade Kreider. Like, he's not the problem. The problem is their defense.
But,
and Trouba's a bad contract. Who's gonna take
him? Yeah, but, like, they could retain, but even at that, like,
no. But bro, Trouba's a disaster. I don't think any team wants him. You know, it's a hard world. You know, with the salary cap.
Yeah. But, like, do you think they're trying to retool, like change the core, like Florida did?
Yeah, I think that's the main idea. But I'm surprised you're doing this randomly in the beginning of the season. Like, normally you do this thing in the off season. So I'm a bit confused about that. But I do get that they want to change the core. But if I was them, I would keep the same core and just try to upgrade the defense, you know, try to upgrade guys like Trouba. I don't know why it's Kreider that they want to trade. Like, he's part of the offense. He's like been playing for this team for a long time. If I was a Ranger, I would calm down a bit. Like, I would say this, maybe it's good. It sends them a message, but I wouldn't actually trade the core. I would just try to retool the defense, you know, and just see what they can bring you. And if the core still fails, then maybe consider it. But in the offseason, you can't do this in the middle of the season. Like, what is going on?
Yeah, so now...
It's a weird situation. We'll keep an eye on that.
So, yeah, now let's move on here.
David Zirachek, according to Frank Saravalli, he said David Zirachek could be traded in the next 24 to 48 hours.
Wow.
He was a 6th overall pick in the 2022 draft, the Juraj Slafkovský draft. And it was a bit weird with Columbus. He didn't get a lot of playing time. And he was probably not happy about the situation. But do you think the Habs could go after him? Or do you think it's going to be another team? Like, the Oilers are also in the mix. Frank Saravalli said it's not the Canucks. But, yeah, what do you think about this?
I mean, if you're Montreal, like, why not? But I don't want to overpay. That's my thing. I don't want to overpay.
100%.
My question is, if they own, I know this might not sound realistic, but if they only ask a second, I'm doing it.
Yeah, for sure. But I don't think that's going to happen. Like, because Frank Saravalli said 5 to 6 teams are asking for a trade. I do think somebody's going to pay a first-round pick or overpay, you know. I wouldn't be surprised. I do wonder, though, why they want to trade Zurichek. You know, he's a good defensive prospect. Like, that does have me wondering maybe about his attitude or things like that. But I think he could be a great pickup. What's your prediction? Where do you think he's going to go?
Call me crazy, but maybe he's going to be with the Habs.
Habs?
No, but realistically, maybe Oilers.
Oilers, yeah. I mean, it could happen, but I think Ottawa, you know? I think it's a team that wants to shake up maybe the team a bit, change the blue line,
Ottawa.
Retool, now with also with Artem Zhub injury. And apparently, Josh Norris is on the trade block. So maybe it can be Josh Norris for David Jiricek.
Oh, yeah.
But anyways, like, this is all just like... you know, maybe I'm yapping, you know, but I'm not an insider. But one thing is sure, this guy is going to be traded soon. And
we'll be on the lookout.
Just to say, like, with this guy, what you're going to get is a good guy with offensive instinct. But the thing I enjoy with him is he's a kind of a Ryan McDonagh style. Like, he blocks a lot of shots and he can hit really hard. But, yeah, his development's not going the best because Columbus keeps, like, alternating between the IHL and the NHL. Well, we'll see where this goes. We'll keep an eye on it, like you said.
Yeah.
So now let's move on really fast. Philip Tomasino was traded to the Pittsburgh Penguins for a 4th round pick. What do you think about this trade for Pittsburgh? and for the
Predators. I mean, I don't know what is Kyle Dubas doing? Like, what is Kyle Dubas doing?
I have another question. What are the Predators doing? Because there's been so many first rounders that they let go, like Askarov, Danty Fabro, this guy. Why do they keep wasting their first round picks? I do think that's a smart trade for Pittsburgh, because they're trying to revive his career, but I don't think it's going to work. It didn't work with Cody Glass. So, yeah, I feel like this won't work, but definitely maybe a good gamble to take.
Yeah, now let's move on to the question of the day here.
Is Matt Rempe drawing more attention than Drake?
Is he selling more the Madison Square Garden than Drake, in your opinion?
In my opinion, he has been. That guy has been insane. And, like, he's been so rough, but he's also so bad that they're sending him to the IHL despite him being aggressive. So that has me wondering a bit about how bad he is.
Yeah,
I don't know why the Rangers just don't keep him in the lineup, because every game he does something and he hits hard on other players, you know. But what do you think about the question?
Yeah, man. I think he can, man. He's pretty popular now in the
Madison Square. He's pretty tough, man.
Popular at the Madison Square Garden. But anyways, guys, thank you so much.
The Rampire State Building.
And thank you so much for coming back to another podcast. Make sure you like, comment, share, and subscribe. And we'll see you guys in the next video.